And at that time, the parliament used to have the members, lady members in the parliament of Islam. When second guided Caliph Sayyidina Umar, second, just 3 years after the death of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, just 3 years after his demise, Sayyidina Umar, in his time of caliphate, I say in his time of government, when he was the ruler, he wanted to pass a bill. He proposed a bill in the parliament of Medina, and he wanted to fix a limit for the dawah of ladies, because practice was that there was no limit for their dawah. They may use any amount as dawah, whether after that they were able to pay it or not. So he wanted a bill to be approved by the parliament that there should be a certain limit on dawah reasonably, so that it is definitely paid to women, to the wife. So he brought a bill as the ruler, as the head of the state, in the parliament. A lady who was a member of the parliament, she stood up on the floor and he challenged the bill which was put by the head of the state, Sayyidina Umar, second guided caliph. And she challenged his view and she said, "Oh Umar, how can you limit the dawah for a lady when Almighty God has not limited it?" So he asked, "Oh lady, where have you got this law from?" Then she quoted a verse of Holy Quran, "Ataytum ihdahunna qintaran." Quran says, even if you have given or committed the heaps of gold as dower for your wife, you are bound to pay them. So she said, she inferred that the word heap of gold, it means Allah Almighty God doesn't want to put any limit. Let it be unlimited, right of right. Sayyidina Umar, the caliph, the head of the state, he said, "Asabat imra'atun wakhta imra'un." The lady is correct and I am wrong. So he withdrew his bill back.